I say good afternoon to all the brothers and sisters in social media land. To our Israelite brothers, to our Christian brothers, to our Islamic brothers, to all of our brothers that have found something to believe in. If what you believe in is making you a better person, then that's a great thing. So shouts out to you. But this video ain't limited to our brothers that are believing in something. This is also dealing with our brothers and sisters that just have a pure conscience and a good motive to live life in a righteous way. Shouts out to you too. To our brothers and sisters that's in Kansas City, Missouri. Kansas City, Missouri ain't no different than no place else. The same thing is happening all over the world, no matter where you look at. In the urban core, in every city, in every state in this country, people are witnessing the same thing, the same identical thing. So, you know, it's a conversation one of our brothers, one of our young kings brought forth today about some of the things that are taking place and what can be done about it. What can be done about some of these things? Well, I'll tell you one thing. It's a tide that's turning. And I don't know if people really realize it. Now, me, myself, personally, I'm a Bible believer. I've been a Bible believer since I was a kid. And so, I believe in prophecy. I believe in the things that are written. Because many of those things I see taking place in the life that we're living right now. Got a young brother that I was talking to. Picked up a couple of brothers when we did the community project down on 27th and Walren at the park that we grew up in. And one of our young kings that we were dealing with, I don't know how many people might know him, but in Kansas City, Missouri, you know, he's of the Baldwin family, and his name is Carlos Costa. We's having a conversation today, trying to figure out where to pick up at. He said, I really would like to pick up with what we're dealing with now, with this COVID-19 and this corona. He said, because surely there's got to be something that's much bigger behind what people see. And we got another one of our young kings out of here in Kansas City, Missouri. His name is Melvin Strong, good friend of mine. We go back quite a ways, and he has some very, very powerful, and simplistic posts on Facebook, giving the brothers and sisters really something to think about, not just from a political level, but just from the standpoint of the life that we're living in. We got a whole generation of young brothers and sisters out there, they ain't lived that long, so they don't know that much. But the one thing all of us got in common is that we do want to find a way to have a decent life in this world that we're living in. Being from the urban core, we don't have much to look forward to. So many of the brothers and sisters that have navigated through the minefields of these streets over the years, now we have gotten a little bit older. We see what's happening. So some of our brothers deal with things from the standpoint of, watch out, because somebody's out there to get you. And that is the mindset of many of our brothers out here in these streets that have become desperate. Now, people say what they want to say about me, but it really don't matter. You know, I'm going to keep it real. I'm going to keep it 100. I'm going to be in touch with these streets till the day I die. If the Most High take me out here in these streets, then so be it. But I ain't going to be sitting on the sideline. We know that they making everything hard. You got fake everything. You got fake eyelashes. You got fake hair weave. You know what I mean? You got fake men. You got fake women. You know what I mean? You got fake dope out here. You got fake alcohol. And with all this stuff that's going on now, we ain't just looking at the government shutting down businesses. They shutting down businesses on every level. Not just the local business in the local community. the local black business that the men shut down, the barbershop shut down, the soul food restaurant shut down. Our people can't seem to make no money, and our people ain't getting no money from the government. And it's amazing. Your government can shut you down, but then at the same time, you turn around and you got to try to get a loan from the government just to stay open. Why I got to pay you back money? Why I got to borrow money for you? See, this is what I'm talking about, systematic schemes, brothers and sisters. If we ain't ready, we're going to be swallowed up. We're going to be swallowed up whole. So you got fake everything out here. And many of our brothers that's out here in the game right now, you know for yourself. They drying up everything, but that's one of the first things that Trump said he is going to go after when this COVID-19 stuff, rather than deal with the issues at hand. He said, well, we about to put a blockade on everybody where the drugs is concerned. Never mind the fact, hey, you know what, drugs is a multi-million dollar business. It has been a multi-million dollar business for many of the forgotten about people, or many of the have-not people. That's the only means that they had to come up. Now, I'm not saying whether it's right or whether it's wrong. I'm just saying it's what it is. It's what it is. And so at this time, you know, in all these cities, they even shutting the drug game down. You know what I'm saying? Brothers that been used to making money in the game can't get money no more. You know what I mean? They can't deal with their lavish lifestyle that they've been accustomed to living while they've been doing what they doing. And now, you know what? It's turning desperate. Desperate people going to do desperate things. So you got the killing in the community ramping up. But it's a major distraction that's going on, because you got a whole lot of our people that's out there in the streets, dealing with the Black Lives Matter, dealing with the riot, dealing with the looting, whatever. Desperate people gonna do desperate things. At the end of the day, you know what? We're gonna have to find a solution to these problems that the men created. You know you ain't got nobody that you can depend on. You can't depend on the political arena. You can't depend on the court system. You can't depend on the justice system. And so eventually, It's gonna get to the point where the only people that you got to depend on is the person that's standing right next door to you. But in this hour right here, that don't even seem possible. But still, I want to tell my brothers and sisters, hey, you know what? Be encouraged. You know, I'm just on there just looking at one of them posters my young King Melvin Strong had put on there. You know, about, yeah, I'd say, you know what? I don't know what it's gonna take to fix it. But I know one thing, we got to start somewhere. So this one, I want to tell many of the older brothers, that have been on the streets, that have managed to navigate their way through this minefield, that have came to a place to where they desire to have some righteousness in their life. They want to raise their family. They want to enjoy their wives and enjoy their children. And now it's like, shoot, you got a target on your back. Hey, man, it ain't but one way. It ain't but one way to get this stuff done. You can't change nothing from a national level, politically. Oh, but we can have a great impact from a local standpoint. Oh, we can have a great impact. We can have a great impact as it relates to these brothers that have chosen to stand behind the pulpit and deal with people. Oh, we can have a great impact with the brothers that have chosen to go into the local political arena, the city councilman, the mayor, the all of this, all these different things. Hey, we are the next generation of old people on the planet. Our wisdom and our experience that came from navigating through this minefield that we've been living in and lived this long, don't believe that our voice won't be heard. It's just a matter of collectively coming together in a particular arena to make these things happen. Now, I'm going to say this, and one of the things that we have a habit of as a people is too many chiefs and there's not enough Indians. I don't want to be no chief. I'd rather be an Indian. I'd rather be the person in the background with the blowtorch. So any brothers and sisters out there, man, if you got a plan, you got an ideal, you bring that thing to the forefront, and let's put some fuel behind it, and let's take off running with something. Now, I'm not saying that this ain't no ministerial thing neither, because I'm not saying that nobody got to believe what I believe. They got to see what I see. I ain't saying that, but all you got to do is open up your eyes. You can see it for yourself. Walk outside. I wake up last night about 11 o'clock to gunfire. Seemed like it was right next door to my house. Came outside, looked down the street, It's the police. They down there busting at somebody. Now, all I see is them blocking off the street. And I'm saying, man, they done killed somebody or somebody dead. But that's not the issue. See, it's going to be many people that get killed. It's going to be many people that die simply because they in the wrong place at the right time. I ain't say the wrong place at the wrong time. Many of them going to be in the wrong place at the right time because of what they doing. If you out here and you trying to find a way to strategically cause your brother to stumble, you're trying to find a way how you can rob your brother, how you can get over on your brother. You know what? You're going to be found at the wrong place in the right time, and you're going to get snuffed out. And ain't no need in worrying about the police dealing with people. So what I'm talking about, my plan is far different than any plan that anybody ever came up with. But my plan only going, this thing that I'm talking about, it's only going to happen when those older brothers that now become the mouthpiece of this generation. You see, like when we was kids, we had older people that became our mouthpiece and spoke for us. Well, now we the older people. Those things that they did didn't work because they never got control over our people. They never got control over the young generation. Now, if I had my way, please, I'd gather up all the old hustlers, all the old players, all the old ones that navigated through this minefield and then found a way to bring something righteous out of their life. I would gather all of them brothers up that can see clearly now. And we would become a terrifying experience to a lot of these hard-head Thundercats. Oh, we would become a terrifying experience. Ain't nobody mad about being dying or being killed in the streets. I done ducked gunfire. Bullets done flew all over. See, ain't nobody worried about that. But you know what? It had to be some terror that's brought upon our people, from our people, not from the police. Because, see, the police ain't killing the bulk of our people. The bulk of our people are being destroyed by each other. But you know what? The older folks, they don't even want to have association with the younger folks. They don't want to be around them. They want shadow, stray away, as though it's not their fault. It's not. It is our fault. It's our fault. Because we the ones that created these monsters. So it is our fault. But at some point, we're going to have to become a terror to our own people. Now, I'm only one person, so that won't fly like that. But if I had my way, I would send a message out there to our brothers and sisters and say, you know what? If you hurting your brother, if you slapping your sister around, if you neglecting your responsibility from the standpoint of fatherhood, if you out here running around with a black hood on, you know what I'm saying, and boots on, with a pistol, looking to do your brother harm, I would like to send a message out and say, boy, you're going to come up missing. You ain't going to come up missing at the hands of the police. You're going to come up missing at the hands of your brothers and sisters that see the demise of your people and see the pain that's being inflicted upon your own people, which really you ain't inflicting pain upon your own people. You really inflicting pain upon yourself. Man, I would love that. Let's send a message out there. And one by one, as they came up missing, it would send a message to the rest of them. Hey, you know what, man? I don't know. I ain't seen him in two or three weeks. Man, you know them old heads, man. They said, well, you know, you don't know. You know what? Why you sleeping? Why you eating? Don't nobody even know. You just disappear. I didn't say that you was killed. I said you just disappeared. Now, the rest remain to be seen. But at some point, there had to be some terror brought up on our people for the things that they're doing. They need to know that if you continue going down this road that you're going, God's going to kill you. But see, God don't have no hands, and God don't have no legs. God don't have no physical body. But he uses men and women that do have the bodies that he had created to do his bidding. It ain't no new thing under the sun. from my standpoint, it say judgment gonna begin at the house of God. When you start talking about the house of God, you're talking about the people that was put in this earth to exemplify righteousness. Whether you know that you were the people to exemplify righteousness or not. Because when righteous indignation rise up, wickedness will be stamped out. But man, I refuse to be around anybody that just, you know, I'm scared of this, I'm scared of that, I'm scared. Man, I'm not dodging no train wreck. I'm not dodging no train wreck. I'm not scared of not near one of these young cats out here. I'm not dodging none of that. Because as far as I'm concerned, these are my children. And what they need is a real good ass whooping. Some of them ain't gonna make it. But I'd rather, you know, and that's one of the great respects that I always have for like the mafia movies and stuff like that, and how those Italians ran their organization. You know, I ain't saying it's right or it's wrong to anybody's eyes, but I'm just telling you that they dealt with their own kind. And anytime any of their own kind crossed the line or went out of bounds, they dealt with their own kind. Their own kind came up missing, and it sent fear and shockwaves into the rest of their own kind so that they could understand who was really in control. See, our people don't have no discipline. We don't have no leadership. We don't have no nothing. And if we're ever going to get it, it's going to start from somewhere. Now, that's just one side, just dealing with the streets. The other side, dealing with the political arena from the local standpoint. Oh, it's a very simple matter. It's a very simple matter. We see through the protests and all this, but our people out there going about it wrong. You see, what we need to do is deal with those people that got put in office that said what they was going to do, said what they wasn't going to do, and then let those voices be heard and then apply so much pressure to them that you're either going to have to leave office or you're going to have to do what you said you was going to do. Now, I'm going to say this again. I ain't never been nobody's leader. I just speak what be on my heart, and I say what I'm feeling. But if it's somebody out there that got a plan, every generation, God gonna give some people a plan. He gonna give some people a plan that'll walk out front, that'll see farther than the average people. Wherever those people at, they need to stand up. They need to stand up, and they need to collectively come together and pull their people together. Now, I done watched many of our young brothers here in Kansas City that have influence, that when they throw a party, I mean, that party is so packed, I mean, so packed that it's sold out. It's people standing outside. You need to take advantage of that opportunity, because what that's doing is that's showing you that the Most High or God or Allah or whoever you want to call him have given you influence to be able to pull large numbers, large masses of people together. And that is an opportunity that you've been given to impart some truths and some things that are good. That when people get through having a good time, they go home and toss and turn and have sleepless nights, because in 3 minutes they heard something that shook the very core of everything that they believed or what they didn't believe. Brothers that have influence, whether it's your business, whether it's your ability to, like I said, pull large people or large masses of people together, whether it's your ability to be a popular individual in this world, you don't just have that for nothing. You have that because you've been given influence in this world amongst your own people for a reason. And if they'll listen to the radio when it say that you about to promote a party or do something grand, then they'll listen to what you got to say when you get the microphone in your hand. But you have to have something to say, and whatever it is that you have to say, have to have some substance to it. Now, I don't know that my brother, my young King Melvin Strong, will get this message. You know, and then on top of that, we got another brother, you know, that we come up with, you know what I'm saying? Just left him today, Mac Warren. We call him Mac Warren. That's Sean Copeland out of Kansas City, Missouri. He's another one that have been given great influence and the ability to pull large masses of people together. I've been on the phone trying to contact and reach all of our local DJs. All of our local DJs who have been put out of work and been put out of business because of this thing, and try to get them on the phone and see, you know what, whatever. Okay, I ain't got no whole lot of money, but I'm going to spend something with. So any local DJs in Kansas City, Missouri, you hearing this man got flagged. pressurized and you got things like that, then you contact me so that we can make sure that we get some people to support you while you going through this downtime. We don't do nothing else. We can buy some flash drives. We can buy some music. You know what I mean? But I'm dealing with all of our brothers that really have the influence, not only the influence to pull large numbers of people together, but also our brothers that have gained influence by spinning music and being able to captivate an audience through the use of MCing and the microphone. It's time out. It's good to have a good time, but we got to start having something to say when we get all of our brothers and sisters together so that when the party is over, they can go home and deal with their nieces, with their nephews, with their sons, with their daughters. At some point or another, we're going to have to find a way to pull our people into the place that they're supposed to be. This is not just limited to Kansas City, Missouri. This is limited to every city. In every urban core, in every city, in every state in this country, and then abroad. Because the days that we coming up on, man, they're unlike anything that we have ever seen. And if we just keep sticking our heads in the sand, hoping that it's going to go away, hoping that the mask going to come off, hoping that the gloves going to come off, hoping that the business going to open back up, hoping that all this stuff, and still reaching out looking for breadcrumbs for people that been having you in poverty for your whole entire life, looking for somebody else to get up and do something, hey, man, we got a major problem. No, folks used to say, if you can't find nothing worth dying for, ain't no need in living. Might as well just go find the nearest cliff and then fall off of it. And I'm reminded of a song that Too Short made, The Ghetto, back in the 80s. And at the end of it, he said, die, nigga, die. Die, nigga, die. Die, nigga. Die, nigga, die, nigga, die, nigga, die, nigga, die, nigga, so black folks can take over. And that's what we're saying right now. If you want to be a nigga in the street that's scared to go anywhere because every time you turn around, you trying to do somebody wrong. If you want to be a nigga in the street that don't take care of his kids, a nigga in the street that don't love them so-called hoes, that woman that God made to keep bringing forth life for the next generation. If you want to be the nigga that don't care about nobody, I'm a real ass nigga, then you're the one that need to die. You need to go on and die and get off the face of the earth so black people can take over. And if this message pricks some of you, then good. You need to be pricked. We got a bunch of spoiled men out here that been too busy sucking on their mama's titty, getting fed cookies and milk, that when the real man come to try to teach you some real things, pull your pants up, hold your head up, and be a man. If you got to be broke on this concrete and stay out here for your kids or stay out here for your wife or stay out here for your sisters and brothers, then that's what you do. We steadily keep got boys being raised up, doing foolishness. Don't go down there and give their whole life to the penal system, for this is a people that have been robbed and spoiled, and they are shut up in holes and hidden in prison houses. Tell me that the Bible ain't true when it prophesied that. Tell me that the Bible ain't true when it say thy sons and thy daughters have fainted. Thy sons have fainted. Like a wild bull, they are hanging on the street corner, like a wild bull taken in a net, and they are full of the fury of Yah. See, a wild bull in a net is just buck wild. To faint is to lose consciousness, not only of who you are, but it's to lose consciousness of your surroundings and everything else, your purpose. This is the condition of many of our people. Our sons have fainted. They have lost consciousness of the powerful people that they are. They have lost consciousness of the men that God meant for them to be. And because they lost consciousness, they don't have no sense of direction, period. So they live their life and waste their life like hanging on the corner, doing nothing. With their pistol on their hip or with their pit bull on their side, like wild bulls taken in a net that they'll snap on anybody walking by. They'll hit the old man in the mouth, then stomp him on the ground, turn around and pull their gun out and shoot him because they are like a wild bull taken in a net, and they're full of all this fury and all of this anger and all this hatred, and they don't even understand why. You've been had, baby. You're being had. And if ain't nobody feeding them cookies and milk, then they mad. They want to hurt somebody. You see, we can't look for the political arena to fix this. Because the political arena ain't going to fix it. Keep not thy silence, Lord. Hold not thy peace and be not still. For lo, thy enemies have made a tumult. They that hate thee have lifted up their head. They have consulted against thy hidden ones and taken crafty counsel against thy people to cut them off, that they never remember who they are. That's the condition that we are in. We've been cut off as a people. We don't know who we are. And because we don't know who we are, we don't exemplify no type of love or righteousness toward one another. There have to be men and women in every generation that will be risen up, that have a righteous spirit on the inside of them and a righteous indignation to come out and go to war behind what's right. Whether the people look like you or whether they don't look like you. But ain't nothing gonna happen if you're sitting on the sideline. If you're sitting on the sideline, ain't nothing gonna happen. I got a plan. I don't particularly care to be nobody's leader, but I got a plan. I definitely got a plan. So on Wednesday afternoon, I'm gonna pull together some of these young brothers, some of these young kings that have navigated their way through this minefield in Kansas City, Missouri, and we're gonna bring that thing to the forefront. We're gonna hear what our brothers got to say, and we're gonna come up with some solutions and some things that we can do immediately to start dealing with some of this stuff, because they're not gonna do it. The police ain't gonna do it unless you go stand in their face. The politicians ain't gonna do it. The city councilmen ain't gonna do it. They ain't gonna do it unless you go stand in their face. And I'm not talking about marching up and down the streets picketing. I'm talking about standing in somebody's face every day, consistently, on a regular basis, until somebody do something. So, you know, this is the hour to put up or shut up. And if you one of the brothers out here that you scared to death right along with everybody else because you don't know how to turn the TV off, you listening to the people that ain't never told the truth in the history of their existence, but you going to be taking your cues from TV and you'll turn a deaf ear at your brother who been walking side by side you in this madness. I don't know what to say. So I'm gonna have an allergic reaction to people that just do all this talking and don't want to do nothing. So I'm going to ask the brothers and sisters that have tuned into this video that Wednesday afternoon, I'll put a post on there, and we're going to bring some of our brothers, what used to be young brothers in Kansas City, Missouri. We're now older brothers. You see, somebody going to have to be the mouthpiece in this generation. And we're going to bring these brothers together. We have some educated brothers, and we have some brothers that ain't never graduated from high school. I ain't never graduated from high school. I dropped out in 11th grade. I ain't never graduated from high school neither. So I don't care what type of things that people try to use to discredit you or to slander your name. You understand what I'm saying? This ain't about no education, because ain't no education, so-called education of this world, can be put on me. I'm living my life according to the life that God gave me. Ain't nobody gonna tell me nothing about the life that I'm living. And you're not going to set no standard for me to live by neither. Who gave you the authority to determine whether I was going to be educated based on if I came through your so-called curricular system, or in other words, your indoctrinational system? I ain't being indoctrinated by nobody. And so we ain't going to fall for that banana in the tailpipe. You can use that. You can try to use the fact that some of the brothers is on child support. They ain't took. Well, we know that child support was created by this wicked system. So anything that anybody try to use, it's going to blow back in their face. We know that some of them are going, oh, well, you know, we looked into his past. He been convicted of drugs, and he been a drug abuser, and he been on. That ain't going to work neither, because we would never be on drugs if these powers that be never brought him into our community and never put him on. You see, whatever condition that we are in as a people, those in opposition are the ones that are responsible for it. So at some point, we're going to have to stop falling for that banana in the tailpipe that causes them to be able to use different things against the people that would choose to come out and start speaking on behalf of all of this foolishness. And then they come on and put something on there to try to discredit us. Well, we wouldn't be in the situation that we're in if it wasn't for you. And so by that standard, it blows back in your face, and we'll use all of those things against you. What we need is some men that'll stand up, some men with some real nuts hanging between their legs. That's what we need. So, on Wednesday afternoon, we're going to try to pull some of these brothers together. And then we're going to try to get something done. And it's not about what we accomplish. Because if we can just pull some of our brothers together and have one mind and then start delegating, looking at each brother's strength. Where is his strength at? Where is, you know, we ain't looking for weaknesses. We ain't looking what brothers can't do. Oh, that nigga can't do that. Oh, that nigga can't do. Oh, that nigga thing. We ain't looking for that. We looking for the strengths. Oh, man, that dude, he can speak good. Man, that dude got a mouthpiece. Man, that nigga, he dressed good. He looks the part. He looks professional. He might not be able to speak, but he looked the part. And when he shows up suited and booted with his hats on and everything, like he said, people going to stop and pay attention. It might be the brother that's in the tennis shoes with the hoodie on that has the ability to speak. You see? It might be another brother. He don't speak good and he don't dress good, but he got money behind him that he can make things happen. See? We need to start looking at our brother's strengths, because our brother's strengths belong to us. We are one people, and we got to learn to understand that, even as the scriptures say, is that in the body there are many members. The hand can't say to the foot, because I'm not the foot, I'm insignificant. The foot can't say to the ear, because I'm not the ear, I'm insignificant. If you cut one body part off, then the whole body is dysfunctional. So we got to learn to start using the strengths of our brothers and sisters, and then looking past the weaknesses. You know what, man? If we don't learn how to, do this stuff, man, we gonna be in trouble. And I tell you all the time, that's why the Bible say we're gonna go through a period of Jacob's trouble. But at some point, it's gonna have to be a turnaround, and we know that it's gonna be a turnaround. And I believe that turnaround is gonna come, that while we in the midst of being in trouble, we're gonna start to understand these things here. Damn. I got piece of the puzzle, but my brother got the other piece. My other brother got the other piece. So what? We got disagreements, but his piece is more important than our disagreement. And once we collectively do what we got to do, we can make some changes. And any brothers anywhere in any city, no matter where you at, if you can make changes that are great, they will spread one city to the next. Just the same way that the wickedness spread one city to the next. One city after one city, brothers start sagging. One city after one city till it was all over the world. One city after one city, these things happen. And so, let's try to find something. And I want to give a shout out to all my brothers in Kansas City, Missouri that's doing big things, that's doing wonderful things, you know. I'm going to try to do my best to support them no matter where they at, no matter what they doing. If they pulling people together, only thing that I want you to understand is that you've been given the ability to draw people and pull people together for a reason. So you have to utilize the microphone when you get the opportunity. Nobody's saying get on there and preach a sermon, but the same way you can put a Facebook post on there that can reach out and grab somebody, that's that spirit inside of you letting you know, hey, this is the other part.
this is the other part. I give you the ability to pull the people together. But what good is it going to be to pull the people together if you don't have nothing to say to them? You need to open up your mouth and say that thing that you got to say when you got the people right there. When we did the skating party in Kansas City, Missouri, it was unlike anything that Kansas City, Missouri had ever seen. We sold out of the skating rink. The skating rink didn't even have a bottle of water left. They didn't have no skates left. They didn't have no snacks left, no candy bars, no nothing. And we pulled all of our people together, and they had a wonderful time. But I said, I don't care. See, we titled the skating party based on the scripture, Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 7, to remember the days of old and to consider the generation that have passed by, to ask the Father, and he'll teach you. Ask your elders, and they shall instruct you concerning the Father's will. And that's what we based it on. And we pulled that thing together, and it was phenomenal. It was so many. It was more people than I ever seen in one place. Just the beauty of the fact that I was the one that headed up. That was awesome. That was awesome. Why is it that they wouldn't let us ever have another one again for such a beautiful event? And I told my cousins and I told my sisters and I told Captain Von Zell, I said, we're going to pull our people together. I said, and I ain't going to need but 3 minutes. If you just give me 3 minutes, just give me the microphone for 3 minutes, I'm going to impart something that's going to cause our people. It's going to reach out and grab them. They ain't going to go home. They're going to have sleepless nights. They ain't never going to be able to forget what they heard or what they seen. And the problem is that we need more people that have a mindset that's bigger, that goes past entertainment. Because when we seek to entertain somebody, we have to bring the word entertainment to the fullness of the definition. That means that when people come and people come in mass numbers, that means that we have detained them so that something can enter into them. Now, in entertainment, as we know it from the rap world, from the TV world, our people have been detained and allowed wicked spirits and wicked thoughts and television program and all of this madness to enter them to a point to where they start living their lives in that manner. But in this hour, when we pull our people together, we are going to entertain, we are going to detain them so that some powerful words, some life-changing words, some real truth, stare you in the face, truth can enter into them. And once it enters, they won't be able to get it out. You ain't going to be able to go back to life as you knew it. Because these words that they entered in you, they're not going to go away. So, in the days to come, this is what we're going to be working on. And like I said before, you know, we just in Kansas City, Missouri, you know what I mean? Prophet is without honor in his own home. That's what the Bible say. I'm not classifying myself as nobody's prophet, but we do apply the word to ourselves. He said, a prophet is without honor in his own home. And we know that Jesus, Yeshua HaMashiach, when he went to his own homeland, he couldn't produce one miracle because they did not see him as he really was. They only seen him as who he used to be. So there will always be people that see, oh, that's Michi. Oh, you know, that's the one that, yeah, you know, they used to do this. Oh, he used to do. And so people going to always see you based on what they know. And because they see you a certain way, they never get the fullness of who you really are and what it is that you really do and what it is that you come to impart. And the Bible says that the Messiah could not produce one miracle when he came into his own homeland because the people could not get past who he once was. So he declared that a prophet is without honor in his homeland. And this is kind of the scenario that we're dealing with. So we expect that. So brothers and sisters, that's just Wednesday afternoon. We're going to try to get something wonderful off the ground. And if we can't do nothing but just start encouraging our people, if we can't do nothing but start pricking some of our young men, because we're going all the way down in the heart of the hood. We're going down in the heart of the hood where our young gangsters got their guns on their hip. We're going down in the heart of the hood. We're going to put them face to face with some of these things that we are saying and see how they respond to it. See what they got to say. See if they can identify with what's being said. But we ain't going don't be afraid of our own children. Damn that. From the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom have suffered violence, and the violent take it by force. You might not like what I say, but I guarantee you, you're going to respect it, because you ain't going to buck up against it. We've been in a battlefield doing war since the beginning of time, since we got here. So we ain't going out like that, period. Now, we ain't calling ourselves no modern-day gangsters and all that, but I'd be damned if we be afraid of our own kids, and that's not going to happen, not on my watch. So all praises to the Most High Heavenly Father. Shouts out to you. That's my baby girl, my baby daughter on the horn, Aubrey Lachey. Shouts out to you. I love you, honey. And I'll be at y'all on Wednesday afternoon.